You are now ready to connect the graph Laplacian, its eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and graph partitioning. But first, some handy facts. I'll just state these without proof. If you need that, please see the paper by Pothen et al. Posted in the instructor's notes. The first key fact is that the Laplacian is symmetric. This follows from its definition. An important consequence of this fact is the second fact. The eigenvalues of the Laplacian will be real-valued and non-negative. I say real-valued as opposed to complex-valued. The Laplacian's eigenvectors will also be real-valued, and we can define them to be orthogonal. If you've forgotten what an eigenvalue and an eigenvector are, here's a quick reminder. Eigenvalues and eigenvectors are paired. Let's let lambda I and q sub I be an eigenvalue and an eigenvector, respectively, of L of g. Then the following holds. Multiplying L of g by its eigenvector gives you a scaled version of the eigenvector. The scaling factor is the eigenvalue. You can also write this differently in matrix form. L of g times q is equal to q times lambda. Q and lambda are matrices. In particular, the columns of q are the eigenvectors of L of g. Lambda is a diagonal matrix, where all the eigenvalues sit on the diagonal. Now what about this orthogonal bit? Orthogonality tells us that the dot product between any pair of eigenvectors will be 0 if they're different, or 1 if they're the same. In more compact matrix notation, q transpose times q is the identity matrix. Now what about this non-negative eigenvalues bit? That tells us that all the eigenvalues are at least 0. Now, a common convention is to assume that we can sort the eigenvalues. So let's do that too. We'll let the eigenvalues with the smaller indices be the smaller eigenvalues. So in this case, lambda 0 is the smallest eigenvalue and lambda 1 is the second smallest. Now here's a third fact which I find especially interesting. It says that the graph G has k connected components if and only if the k smallest eigenvalues are identically 0. This is a fact due to Fiedler. Now when I first learned this fact, I was like, wow. I mean, OMG wow. Like seriously, as in S-R-S-L-Y seriously. It's a cool fact because it says the graph Laplacian spectrum, meaning its eigenvalues, tells us something about the underlying connectivity of the graph. Here's one more important fact. Let's say you have a graph that's been partitioned into two pieces. One piece is the plus piece and the other piece is the minus piece. Let's let V plus be the set of vertices in the plus piece and V minus the set of vertices in the minus piece. Now this is all graph language. What about the linear algebra side? Let's define a vector x with respect to this partition. Each entry of x will correspond to a particular vertex. We'll assign that entry a positive 1 if the vertex lies in V plus and a minus 1 if the vertex is in V minus. Now suppose you want to count the number of edges that are being cut in the graph. This leads us to our fourth fact. The number of cut edges is this product, 1/4 x transpose L times x. This fact is also very nice. It says that if you want to minimize edge cuts, you should try minimizing this product. Okay, so let's quickly summarize the four facts. Take a moment to digest them. Once you've done so, you're ready for the spectral partitioning algorithm.